Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Monday edition of Source 16 News. I'm Eddie Owen. Thanks for joining us. Topping our news, police are continuing to investigate the weekend murder of a 2-year-old Hopkins County boy. According to police, 2-year-old Caleb Higgins of Highland Avenue, Earlington, was rushed by ambulance to Regional Medical Center in Madisonville Saturday morning, where he was pronounced dead a short time later. An autopsy revealed that the child died of multiple blunt force trauma to his head and body. The Hopkins County Sheriff's Department arrested and charged the father's girlfriend, 28-year-old Alexis Mays of Earlington, with murder. Now, if anyone has any information that may assist law enforcement, please contact the Hopkins County Sheriff's Office at 270-821-5661. A fatal motorcycle wreck on Tiny Town Road in Montgomery County this morning claimed the life of a 33-year-old Clarksville man. Clarksville Police spokesman Jim Knoll reports the accident occurred around 3:20 near the intersection of Terra Boulevard when the 33-year-old man was thrown from his 2004 Harley-Davidson motorcycle, which traveled over 100 more feet after the rider was ejected. At this point, police say it has not been determined why the rider, who was not wearing a helmet, lost control of the bike. As of news time, police have not released the name of the man killed pending notification of family. Two Graves County men were killed and two other men are in critical condition after an accidental electrocution over the weekend. Mayfield Police and Fire Department arrived at a home on East College Street around 1 o'clock Saturday afternoon and found 68-year-old Rayburn Sanderson Sr. and 60-year-old Willie J. Martin, both of Mayfield, dead and two others badly injured after they had been trying to move a large CB radio antenna when it fell into power lines. Graves County Coroner Philip McLean arrived on the scene and pronounced the two men dead, and the other two injured men were taken to Jackson Purchase Emergency Room and then transported to Vanderbilt Medical Center in Nashville. Mayfield police are still investigating that incident. A Fort Campbell EMS worker has been arrested and charged with sodomy. According to the Christian County Sheriff's Department, 40-year-old Edward Carr Jr. of Crofton was arrested Sunday night at 10:45. In a statement to the Department of Child Services caseworker, which was overheard by Captain Chris Miller, the report said the victim said that on a Saturday morning between March 1st and March 31st, Carr had her perform a sexual act on him. The victim reportedly said that the most recent occurrence took place in Carr's bedroom at his Grapevine Road residence in Crofton. Police say Carr spontaneously admitted to a sheriff's detective, "My career is over, my family is over," but refused to give a statement after he was read his Miranda rights. Carr was charged with third-degree sodomy and booked into the Christian County Jail. Well, what does the latest census data say about Christian County? Kentucky Education and Workforce Development Research Statistics Director Ron Couch spoke about census data numbers to the Pennyryle Area Development District's Board of Directors at their regular monthly meeting today.
You have Christian County on the first page here. This is the new census data, 2000-2010. You notice Christian County was projected, actually, your estimates were showing and projections showing you were growing by 12,000 people. The new census data came out, and I'm sure I know the mayor and the judge were not very happy. We're only about 1,600 people. Okay? You'll also notice from those numbers, folks, that part of that is you'll see your military age population went down. So part of the issue in Christian County may have been that basically you had people deployed overseas during April of 2010, which lowered your population. My concern is that those people be put back into the numbers when they come back. You'll notice in Christian County, it was not just your population of military age that went down, your young population didn't go very much.
Couch also told the Board of Directors he was shocked to learn that Christian County only had 400 more students than last year. Well, the city of Madisonville wants to protect you from identity theft, and once again, they're sponsoring a free shred day. Madisonville residents can bring your personal or business documents up to 100 pounds to the Parkway Plaza Mall parking lot by the Capitol Theater from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Saturday. If you have any questions or want more information on shred day, contact Linda Sandage at the city of Madisonville, 270-824-2100. And if you stop by Mayfield's City Hall, you'll see a table set up for an ongoing silent auction to raise money for the City Employees Relay for Life team. Mayor Teresa Cantrell says items on the table range from duck decoys to screwdriver sets, and several local gift certificates are available as well. She notes that items for the auction were donated by local businesses for prizes for the recent disc golf tournament. But with a low attendance due to the weather, there were some door prizes left over from the event. The silent auction will continue through Friday at noon. At that time, Mayor Cantrell says all winning bidders will be notified to pick up their items and to pay for them. Three Graves County residents were arrested this morning and charged with drug trafficking. Police arrested and charged William Davis, Dennis D.J. Wilson, and Santana Cope on several charges, including trafficking marijuana and trafficking a controlled substance within 1,000 yards of a school. According to Mayfield Police, officers made a traffic stop on South 2nd Street on a vehicle that Davis was driving because he was suspected of driving under the influence. Upon further investigation, police say it was determined that the occupants of the vehicle had been delivering marijuana to individuals in another location. Officers contacted the other people in the parking lot behind Wyatt Crossing just off Charles Drive and found several baggies of suspected marijuana and some prescription medications not in their original container. Davis, Wilson, and Cope were booked into the Graves County Detention Center. Two other individuals were cited to court. Meanwhile, a 22-year-old Christian County man was arrested and charged with drug trafficking over the weekend. According to Hopkinsville Police, officers served a search warrant at a Pine Hill Drive home Saturday night and found about two and a half pounds of marijuana with an estimated street value of $9,000. Also, Loratab pills and over $3,000 in cash and drug paraphernalia. 22-year-old Joseph Brown of Hopkinsville was taken into custody and charged with trafficking in marijuana, 8 ounces to 5 pounds, possession of drug paraphernalia, and possession of a controlled substance. Brown was booked into the Christian County Jail. Well, a Hopkinsville woman who police reportedly stopped for not wearing a seatbelt was arrested after officers found multiple drugs in her vehicle. Upon contact with the driver, Hopkinsville police say 37-year-old Misty Samples appeared extremely nervous with red, glassy eyes and rapid speech. After a canine unit hit on the vehicle, police found multiple pills, a small amount of marijuana, and drug paraphernalia in the SUV as well as inside Samples' purse. She was taken into custody and charged with 2 counts of possession of a controlled substance, possession of marijuana, and drug paraphernalia. Samples was lodged in the Christian County Jail. A traffic stop for speeding landed a Graves County man behind bars facing various charges, including selling alcohol illegally and to a minor. Mayfield police stopped 58-year-old William House of Mayfield on Beach Street Friday morning and requested permission to search his vehicle, where officers found a subject under the age of 21 in possession of alcohol. Authorities then went to House's Beach Street residence after getting a search warrant, and police found a large quantity of various brands of alcohol as well as marijuana. House was charged with selling alcohol to a minor, unlawful transaction with a minor, unlicensed sale of alcohol, possession of marijuana, firearm enhanced, and other offenses. He was lodged in the Graves County Detention Center. Being a mother is a full-time job, especially for military mothers who are currently deployed in Afghanistan. In a report from Task Force Kurahi, First Lieutenant Monica Baker says, despite being deployed on Mother's Day, she emailed and called her mother and daughter. Meanwhile, Specialist Geraldine Duenas celebrated Mother's Day by sending flowers to her mother. The specialist says, being so far away from my mom makes me miss her more. It makes it difficult to stay connected with not only her, but also the rest of my family. Motorists who travel Highway 91, the Princeton Road in northern Christian County, could experience a slight delay due to paving work set to begin tomorrow. The Kentucky Transportation Cabinet's milling and paving work will run along Princeton Road from Mount Carmel Road around the 10-mile marker to the Christian Caldwell County line, a distance of about 5 miles. Traffic delays should generally be less than 4 minutes. However, spokesman Keith Todd says delays may be slightly longer during the movement and placement of equipment as crews go about their work. The milling and paving work in this area is expected to take about a week, weather permitting. Well, here's a look at some upcoming chamber events brought to you by the Hopkinsville Christian County Community Vision Plan. One of the chamber's newest members, All Bark and No Bite, will host a ribbon cutting Wednesday morning at 11 o'clock at 3804 Lafayette Road, Hopkinsville. Some other upcoming events include the chamber's Give 'em the Pickle training workshop. That'll be held tomorrow at 11 at the Commerce Center on Fort Campbell Boulevard. The cost is $15 per person. Seats are going fast. To RSVP, contact the chamber at 270-885-9096 or online at hopkinsvillechamber.com. And the League of Women Voters will host Robin Oakley at the Christian County Board of Education office Thursday night to discuss what changes can be expected in our local education as a result of Senate Bill 1. The discussion begins at 7 o'clock at the Board of Education at 200 Glass Avenue. Now, these chamber events are brought to you by the Hopkinsville Christian County Vision Plan. Hope your numbers are ready because Tuesday's Mega Millions jackpot is $18 million. Wednesday's Powerball jackpot is $65 million.